Okay, Professor Leiko also said that dapat daw pag nag-ECQ, dapat, you know, they should be doing what they ought to do, which is really to prepare for the reopening, kumbaga for the loosening up, no? Ang nangyayari nga raw ngayon is nag-ECQ lang para lang ma-relieve yung current situation. So if we extend realistically, what can we really do on a longer term in order to avoid having to declare ECQs or MECQs when the numbers rise? Hospital-wise, kunyari, nakatulong ba yung step-down system? Nakatulong ba yung pagtatayo ng mga tents or COVID centers or yung mga quarantine facilities? Di ba nakatulong yun, ma'am?
Nakatulong naman yon, no, Lucci? Pero I think it is only a stopgap measure, no? It's short-term only. At the time when the hospitals are really filled up and there's no other place where people can go to when they need to be admitted to the hospital. So in a way, nakatulong yan at this particular time. But whether it is going to help in on long-term, I don't think so. Because this is a short-term measure that is being put into place just to address the current problem that we have as far as the hospital capacity is concerned. But what we really need, I also agree, no, na itong mga community quarantine measures that are imposing right now, they are also short-term measures. So hindi siya pang matagalan. And we cannot really afford to have, and I have to agree, even if I'm not a businessman, I have to agree that prolonging the community quarantine too long will really have a negative impact on the economy and even per family, no, yung livelihood nila. It's going to have a negative impact. So what we really need are long-term programs that should be put into place, and that should include rigorous contact tracing. No, na interoperable dapat yan with every city or even every LGUs within the country. And we have not seen that happening yet.
I can speak of the hospitals, no? Especially the government hospitals, because in fairness to the Department of Health, we're really trying to increase our capacity despite the what we call shortage of manpower, no? Because what we're trying to prove here that we really can handle these cases, no? But there are always limitations, and sometimes even with when you have this bed capacity, but the number of workers are not that also in terms of full force, because some are sick, some are on leave, and you know, we've been battling this pandemic for almost a year, and you really have to expect fatigue, and at this point in time, no? So there are efforts, and we are trying to really, as much as possible, accommodate. I think one of the, as I always mentioned, no, ang pinaka ground battle ng pandemic nito is really in the community. Dahil nandoon yung contact tracing and isolation. And looking at patients na na-admit ngayon, makikita mo talaga the household transmission, magkakapamilya-pamilya. And hindi ko alam kung was there enough contact tracing, isolation in the community, because all of these patients started with a mild infection before they go into the hospital because of severe and critical.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So okay. So what is your sense nga, Doc, of this flexible MECQ? Will that actually relieve the situation in terms of the household contagion that's taking place?
Ganito yan, Lucio, ang tingin ko, no? Para tayong umikot-ikot lang nito. Pag tumataas ang kaso, we instill lockdown. Pag bumababa naman, we lift it, no? Sana meron tayong tinatawag na palpable sustained measures, both in the especially in the community. Kasi kung puro tayo lockdown nito, ang sasabihin lang naman natin, nagsasuffer ang economy. We need more palpable and highly descriptive way of the implementation on the ground. Yun ang tingin ko dito. Dahil ang healthcare facility resources natin, hindi naman yan drastically na mag-improve kaagad. It takes time. marami pang ayusin yan, no? But we really are trying our best to accommodate a lot. Majority of the cases are mild. Nandun yan sa community.
Go ahead.
Can you be more specific? Ano yung palpable measures? Are you talking about parameters or actual measures that can be implemented to prevent, eto na nga, yung paulit-ulit tayong lockdown, tapos bukas, lockdown, bukas?
Actually, there are already measures. I don't know to what extent are these measures being 100% followed. How many percent of these are being implemented and followed? Yun lang yung siguro nakikita ko. I'm not with the LGU. I don't know what's going on sa level na yan. But I can see most of these patients pag na-admit talagang galing naman yan sa barangay, sa community. At tinatanong mo, o yung mga na-expose sa inyo, tinitest ba or something like that? Sasabihin lang, hindi nila alam. Sabihin pa nga, nagtatrabaho pa yung na-expose sa bahay nila. Sabi ko, ako, talagang delikado. Hindi tayo matatanggal sa ganitong klaseng situation.
So, contact tracing, in short.
Napaka-importante.
Yung sense nyo is, hindi yun na susunod. Is that your sense? We're not fast enough in actually identifying the list of contact of persons that were in contact, ganun.
Ganito yan, Dulce. No? When one is positive, nandun na siya sa hospital, dun pa lang yung data may reflect dun sa barangay. That's already 5 days, 7 days. Kailan ka magkocontact tracing? 10th day, 11th day. The 24 hours, 48 hours after that na-admit mo yung pasyente, ang dami na nung lumabas doon yung mga na-quarantine o nakahawa na hindi na, I mean, yung contact niya na nasa bahay, lumalabas, nagtatrabaho, hindi pa na-contact trace, hindi pa na-test.
Curious nga ako eh, bakit ganon? Is it because people are not really reporting, you know, their health? Kunyari, nagkasipon or nagka-fever pero ayaw i-report. Kaya tuloy, hindi rin alam na mga kasama niya sa bahay or kapitbahay niya or katrabaho niya na actually may sipon na siya or may fever na siya. Ganun ba yun?
Yeah,
is that your sense of it?
Yeah, that's the other factors. No? Kasi kadalasan talaga, ayaw sabihin na meron silang sin. This virus has created an element of stigma. Maski sa bahay or sa mga ano. Kasi diba nakikita natin, pag nag-positive ka, i-isolate mo yung bahay, tapos hindi ka na makalabas. That's the other stigma that goes with it.
Doc, na